Thank you so much, Randy. We are in the middle of preparations for a huge art showcase. It's called the Artsy Black and White Ball, Black and White Masquerade Art Ball. We have Jacqueline Craig. She's the head curator of Artsy and Black Seance Company.
Guys.
And we have a few things and a few people
going
on here.
You brought the heat.
I see that. Can we just start over here and tell me just what's going on over here and tell me about the artists that you curated for the show?
We got Brooke right here. This is actually another Artsy member, head curator, head graphic designer of Artsy, actually the OG of Artsy.
I see that. He's sounding like he's an OG.
Oh, yeah, definitely. He's the king. Now, right here, we're just going to float around.
We have a
float of artists, Stu.
So we have Stu.
Everybody say what's up.
What's
Introduce yourself.
And his brother right here. And then also, I see, we have this gorgeous look.
Yeah,
gorgeous woman right here. We have some sketch artists here. Can you tell me a little bit about the type of artist that you definitely want people to see in this show?
Well, with us, with Artsy, we don't have any limitations. We don't have any boundaries, so it's open.
Okay.
So basically, we never want to take away from any artist and their creativity at any point. So we want them to be able to fully express themselves however they feel they want to do that with their craft. So we don't really have any major stipulations or boundaries to art, because there's no boundaries in art.
Now, I see that we can have things that are either very, very free and loose, almost like watercolors, but then
we
also have something very structured here.
Absolutely,
as well.
With Zeus, absolutely. And then we have Bird right here, who always come bring the heat. Then we have Rage Ross right here, who's just phenomenal. And then we have McGinnis over here, who's back on us after a year in the closet. He's back out.
Come on out, you gotta go ahead, come on out. We have Vincent Lang. He's head photographer of Artsy and Black Seance Company. So tell me about the approach to your art.
The approach to my art, I really try and capture the moment. What I specialize is in candid. So I've been the historian for Artsy, for what we do in the community, as far as just overall capturing the history of the art in the making.
Okay.
So we've been able to have 12 months of actually producing the First Friday Art Walk down in Old North. And we have about 12 months of photographs that actually show that history as well. So it's been wonderful. And not only do we do that as far as capturing the history, but we're able to provide high resolution photographs to the artists as well for the art to actually make prints of.
So I do think that is critical for artists who are trying to get out there and trying to get in the media, because I can tell you, just as a producer, I'm like, can you please send me some high res stuff? And I get it.
Right.
So thank you so much for that.
Yeah.
Everybody, I need you all to stay tuned to Fox 2 News 9 a.m. at about 9:40. We are definitely going to make sure that you guys see the finished products for all of these artists. But until then, be ready for the Artsy Black and White Masquerade Art Ball at the Zach on January 6th from 7 until midnight.
Yeah.
3224 Locust Street in downtown St. Louis. Go to Eventbrite and just search Artsy. Again, stay tuned. Fox 2 News, 9 a.m. Art lives here. Time to toast to the new year with ice cream? We are bad in such a good way with Clementine's naughty and nice creamery boozy flavors. And in just a few, we up.